Minister, I'm sure you're aware the very fine Kildare equine tradition is second to none, not just in Ireland, but in the world. Its potential is probably still unfulfilled. It should be the world leader and HQ of the equine industry. If you put together what the Crucible Theatre in Sheffield means to snooker, Alexander Palace means to darts, and the Wembley Stadium means to soccer, FA Cup final, you would still not fully appreciate the love, the care of horses in Kildare, and also the economic dividend. Horseport Ireland is working very hard, as you know, Minister, under the able stewardship of Joe Reynolds and many others like Miss Avalon Everett, John Moran, doing very well, great work in COVID times. But they would like, and they have about 25 affiliates, including horse breeding, they would like to have that put on a statutory, regulatory footing. Like 14,000 jobs are generated by his activities, 816 million generated income each year. They've proudly, we will have three separate teams that qualified for the Olympics next year, from dressage to show jumping to eventing, plus a Paralympic dressage. And then if you go to their spiritual cousins, horse racing, you know, over 1 billion generated from horse racing, over 28,000 direct, indirect secondary jobs, 1.3 million attendees at Irish racing, 1.84 billion total direct and indirect stimulus for the Irish economy. Of course, expenditure by racecourse is estimated to be 145 million. So my one appeal today is Horseport Ireland in Naas, they're doing great work, but they have a temporary home. I would not like to see Horseport Ireland leave the county. We need a collaborative approach. We would urge you, Minister, and I appreciate this will be a cross-departmental approach from tourism to sport to agriculture. We already have Martin Hayden very enthusiastic about this and always was, Junior Minister Hayden, in my neighbouring Kildare South constituency. And I hope that Horseport Ireland, it's like what Crow Park and Semple Stadium, they're the spiritual home of the GA. The spiritual home of the horse is Kildare. We don't want to see it fragmented. We don't want to see Horseport Ireland relocate its HQ outside the county. For instance, Punchestown, I live very close by. They do great work there, very generous to the public to use it, walking and share it with so many other amenities and local communities. Under David Mungie and so many others, both past and his predecessors, have put Punchestown on the map. They have lots of space, huge potential. In a collaborative approach, from mounted games to pony clubs to disabled riders, have a HQ only on a far bigger scale than Abbottstown. Oh, they have lots of land, huge potential. You would bring tourism throughout the world to Punchestown if we can sit down with your minister and make sure we don't miss this opportunity. And I forgot to congratulate you. I know you're a passionate Cavan man, and you had a brilliant week, as had Tipperary, and commiserations to the minister from Donegal.
That's very gallant of you. Thank you very much.
Very sporting.